I recently went to an exhibition of Australian painter Arthur Streeton at the Art Gallery of New South Wales. I took my sketchbook along and spent a few minutes sketching one of the paintings on display. It got me thinking about the concept of stealing or copying from other artists. Words like copying and stealing don't sound good when you're talking about taking other people's work and using it in your own work. But if you think about it, if you saw someone sketching in an art gallery, would you say that they were doing something wrong? Yeah, they might be copying the work, but they're really just trying to understand how the artist is thinking. In reality, copying other artists is actually one of the best ways that you can learn and improve in your own work. But if you're going to copy, copy the greats. Research who the masters are in your particular medium. Look at the work of your absolute favorite artists and just sit down and copy their work. You'll be surprised how much you can learn just from doing this. So at the exhibition, I bought a book of Arthur Streeton's paintings. He primarily paints with oils and I'm more of a watercolour painter, but in the book I did find a few paintings that seemed to be watercolours. When you copy the work of a master, it's like seeing into their mind. You can start to understand the decisions that they make when it comes to layout of the scene, the color choices, the values, and even the way that they apply the paint on the page. For Christmas, I was given this beautiful book of watercolors by John Singer Sargent, who is one of my favorite painters. After copying a few of his paintings, I started to realize he loves purple and yellow and purple and orange and combining those colors together. They're obviously opposite on the color wheel, and I've never personally used that much purple or yellow in my paintings before, but since I've started copying his work, I've started to realize how great that combination is, and I've been using it a lot more in my own painting. I've also learned not to define everything and to let parts of the painting become almost abstract and let the viewer figure out what's going on for themselves rather than explaining everything really literally. I've also learned the bushes of blobs, and there's pretty much no point trying to get detailed on a tree or a bush or lots of little leaves. It's best to just leave it a bit messy. At least that's how Sargent likes to do it. Another really important thing I've learned is that shadows can be warm and full of light. Previously, if there was any kind of shadow, I would just go straight for the ultramarine blue and maybe mix in a little bit of burnt sienna, and that was it. I didn't really quite know what people meant when they meant reflected light, but after looking at Sargent's paintings, I really have started to understand that a lot better, because he is just a master of reflected light. I've also learned to sketch out man-made forms and people, but when it comes to natural objects, just let your brush do the talking. With a lot of Sargent's paintings, you can see the pencil lines underneath, and you can see where he's spent the time to really get the drawing right, and you can see where he's kind of just let it go a bit more, and it seems to be the more natural shapes he doesn't draw as much at the beginning, and with the more man-made shapes he does get those right ahead of time, which kind of makes logical sense, but it's not something that I've really thought about before. But since implementing that into my own work, I've started to realize that that's actually a really great way to keep natural things looking natural, is don't lock them down with a drawing ahead of time too much, and just let your brush do the talking. So those were some really important things I've learned literally just from doing a few studies of Sargent's work. So I would really encourage you, if you've got an art book or just find some images online of your favorite artists, and copy them out and just give them a go. It does help to know what medium they're painting in, just so that you can ideally use the same medium just to make things a bit easier. But at the same time, you can even just sketch with a pencil. You could sketch a painting with a pencil, which is what I did at the art gallery. I just sketched that out with a water-soluble graphite pencil and a water brush, and that's all I had. So you really don't need to have exactly the same tools. It just might help if you're trying to get very accurate likeness of the painting. If you need a bit of inspiration, I would suggest looking at John Singer Sargent, also Joseph Zbukvic, and also Sherry Blauklopf. I think that's how you pronounce her name. I've been really enjoying her work recently. She's an urban sketcher and she just does amazing stuff with colour. So if you're looking for someone to copy when it comes to colour, she's the person to go for. My name's Josie. I post videos about watercolour and sketching every single week. I'm moving into a new house in a couple of weeks and I'm going to be redesigning a YouTube art studio for myself. So if you want to see that, then just hit the subscribe button and I'll be sharing what I'm getting up to with my new studio, which I'm very excited about. But for now, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.